We dated from 16 to 18, and then we graduated, kind of went our separate ways.
They then had their own lives and ended up kind of rekindling the love 35 years later.
Part two of our love story. Met her on the beach, took her for a day. And we've been married for about 3.5 years.
We're both retired. Now we want to just enjoy. So we were living in a 750-square-foot house right down the street.
In a cute little cottage that we had renovated. It was very manageable. It was actually a fun challenge for us.
And I don't know, Susie wanted to go bigger.
And we bought this house about 4 months ago.
We're sure we didn't want those countertops, right?
Too late.
We knew the kitchen was the first thing that had to go. We wanted to change that from day one.
And, you know, I want to keep Susie happy.
Oh, yeah, just rip it right out.
We started breaking into things.
Is that a load-bearing wall?
I know I've exposed the wall, but I don't know what I'm looking at.
People think that, you know, their experience from one house is going to help them in the next house. It doesn't always work that way.
We know we want to try and make this wall flush. Dang, where do we go from here?
It was extremely daunting. We don't have excess money to spend or blow or try things out.
Gotta call in the pros.
They're not having fun. They're not making progress. They want to enjoy their retirement. They want to enjoy the time that they have together. So by calling me, they're gonna be able to hand it off, get it finished, and move on to the next chapter.
Hi, Jasmine.
Hi.
How's it going? Good, how are you?
I'm so good.
I am so excited to learn about the floor plan of this house.
Our crazy house.
From the outside, it looks like a box, but all of a sudden you get inside and it's a maze.
How many stories is the actual house?
6 levels.
So let's try to make it up to the kitchen.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay.
Let's go.
I'll follow you because I'm going to get lost otherwise.
We truly do call this a maze.
It's cool, right?
Oh, we love it.
It's weird and it's quirky. But
kind of like us.
By the way, this doesn't look like a house that's been wrecked.
Oh, well, just wait. We're at level 5.
Oh, wow.
This is our living space, where we hang out. This is where we spend a lot of our time. I mean, there's things we love about it, and there's things that are challenging.
I got up in the middle of the night because I heard a bunch of noise, and all of a sudden, water was just pouring down from that slider. Right here, it was just pouring down, hitting the wood, pouring down right here. And I did put a bead of caulking around the fireplace. But did it work? I don't know.
You got on the roof of a 6-story house?
Yes, I risked my life.
Truly.
We have to figure out what's going on because that's concern number one. Concern number two is all the things that Jimmy has already tried to do.
So this is where you started actually doing some work, it looks like.
Yep. Going from a small space that we could see the light at the end of the tunnel almost before we started the work. Coming here, we didn't know where to start. So we kind of started just digging in.
I see that you tore into the beam.
Well, our thought was we would love to have an exposed beam in the kitchen.
Whoa.
Whoa. Watch yourself.
Okay.
We found a beam.
Yeah, like what was your plan? Like if I was not here.
I don't know.
What happened here?
We just decided to find out what was behind there.
Our thought was we would take down this wall if we could, just to kind of give a clean line for the kitchen.
Then you start pulling the wall to here.
Right.
How does all this work?
Right. Well, that's kind of why we stopped. Our small cottage was easy breezy, super fun. We actually enjoyed doing it together. But it kind of started feeling overwhelming as we were breaking into these different areas. So we just thought, you know what, we better put things on hold until we have a bigger and a better plan.
This is not the type of project you could do yourself. I mean, it must be hard to live here. You don't have appliances that are working.
Right.
You have rubble in your kitchen.
We like
to entertain. She likes entertaining.
I definitely haven't found my groove.
Yeah.
So I'm excited to start cooking again.
This kitchen is tiny. I mean, for the size of the house.
Don't like it at all. I would love to see like an island where I could access from both sides, which is why we've demoed this area. But I do know if we reconfigure the kitchen, there's gonna be flooring issues.
Well, there'll be holes in the flooring. Were there any boxes of flooring or anything that you found when you purchased the house?
There was a couple.
I have to be really careful because we have to protect these floors.
Right. This is definitely where we need help.
It's such a confusing layout, truly. You know, Susie and Jimmy had this really romantic idea of the house, and right now, this is not that house. Okay, Scott, so let me walk you through what I'm thinking. The living room is mostly a cosmetic refresh. Furniture, accessories, that's what's gonna make it feel really cozy. I wanna do a complete overhaul of the fireplace, so we'll remove the surround and cover it with an overgrouted, rough-cut veneer stone, and then replace the existing mantle with a beautiful wood mantle, and I think that's gonna make it feel updated and a little bit more eclectic, more Susie style. So for the kitchen, I don't even know where to start. We'll get rid of this column, we'll get rid of the entire countertop here, and that'll leave room for an island. That'll give us a double entry into our kitchen. We'll ground the island by painting it a beautiful dark gray, and we'll center the sink on the window. Our range will go next to the sink, and then we'll move the refrigerator to the opposite wall. We'll build custom white shaker cabinets around the entire perimeter. For the backsplash and countertops, I think we should go with a really soft gray quartzite, and then we'll wrap the beam in oak to give Susie and Jimmy that architectural feature that they've been looking for. Oh, and to solve the problem of the dysfunctional corner, I think we should square off the room with an entrance to the pantry.
Ah, that's a good use of space for the pantry. I like it.
I think so too.
Yeah.
With this old kitchen gone, it's gonna be so much easier to finalize the new layout of the new kitchen.
Hi, Jasmine.
Hi, Jasmine. Gosh, we can't wait. We're so excited.
I am so excited for you to see what we've done.
I have my fingers crossed.
Wait, in a good way or
in
bad
a good way?
Way?
That's gonna flow.
I think it makes sense for just the two of you to go in, see your new house, and then I'll come find you in a little bit.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
I love the floors. Awesome.
Sweet.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, look at this. This is like the perfect living space. It is better than I could have imagined. I love this.
Don't cry.
I know, it's too soon, huh? Oh, look at the fireplace.
I love the mantle.
It is amazing.
Oh, my gosh. This is ridiculous.
Looking incredible. It is absolutely gorgeous. Oh my gosh.
Guys!
Oh, there she is!
Oh my gosh! I love it so much. Oh, I love it all.
Yes, right? I mean, okay, let's start back over here.
Phenomenal. I cannot believe what you did with these floors.
I mean, we really didn't have a choice.
Oh, my gosh.
But at the end of the day, I think it was a win.
Oh, a huge win.
And gosh. I don't even know how you stitched them in where there was that peninsula. And now the floor just looks like it's the same. She's a miracle worker.
I don't know about that. Let's not go that far. But I do think it makes a big difference, right?
Yeah. I haven't purchased furniture. I feel overwhelmed. I need help. This is like a good hangout spot. So us. Comfy, cozy, and coastal.
I feel like you dressed to sit in this room.
Our Christmas picture will be done right here.
I love that. And then the fireplace.
Oh my gosh.
Wait, do you remember what the fireplace looked like before?
Because gothic.
Gothic, yeah.
I wanted it to feel really organic.
Yeah.
I mean, it is the focal point of the room. So this is an architectural stone that we overgrouted.
I think it's awesome.
And then the other challenge was what in the world to do with this space to figure out the furniture. So each of you take a seat. I'm really proud of this.
Oh,
you can look at the TV.
Look at this.
They rotate.
We're going to have fun in these chairs. I can tell.
Oh, yeah.
I love that you can get from the eating area into the kitchen so easily.
This was the only way in, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this is a big island.
I know. This is perfect.
So these countertops are quartzite, and they were actually cut out of a mountain in Brazil. They're super durable.
That's harder than granite, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
This was seen like a big kitchen, but just bad design. But now it looks so big. It's ridiculous.
Just what I wanted.
What about the beam?
The beam just kind of blended in with everything else. Now it's making a statement.
It's actually custom carpentry that's over what was there. This is now like the architectural feature of this room.
I love it.